Hey guys, Thomas Kanemoto here with the Bass Hookup. It's November 2nd. It's the first day of two pre-fish days for the ABA Team Classic. I've already come out once a couple weeks ago. My brother came out this last Saturday, and he struggled. He had around 10 pounds for his best five. He fished shallow all day. I'm not gonna give up on the shallow pattern, so I'm gonna start today on a shallow bank here on the north end of Clearlake, and then from here on out, probably 80% of my day is gonna be spent deep. And I'm gonna look for some ledges, some rock piles, throw some like 6XDs and some Norman DD22s and maybe drag a jig. Let's get started on this little flat right here with these docks and see if there's some fish shallow, and then we'll work our way out. Here we are again, Clearlake. It's day number two. My brother, he's still by himself. I don't get there till the next day after this, and this one is a lot slower. Still gonna show you the whole day, but just it's a lot slower. It's a rougher day. If you saw the first video, the first day was really good. He was only out there a couple hours and caught a couple nice fish.
There's another one. That one came up shallow right there. That was a shallow fish. Oh, in the eye.
But this day is a lot tougher. You know, me as his brother, I'm always sitting at home looking at the weather and going, man, it's gotta be good. Look at, it's cloudy. You know, you just got him the day before. He's probably just stroking him, but a lot of times that's just not the case. So, you know, I always call and see how he's doing, and I'm always surprised when he has like a rough day. But he just throwing that little swim bait on the underspin around Kona Te'i here, and nothing big, just small fish on this day. He catches a decent one right here, but for Clearlake, you need 4 and 5 plus pounders every T.O.C. to even compete.
Fatty right there.
And he's catching them pretty quick in this area on Kona Te'i. All these docks, they always have fish. There's always boats there. There's boats in most places around Clearlake when you fish a T.O.C. So, no surprise.
That one came on the Blade Runner with the Kitech 4.3 Tennessee Shad. Just crawling on the bottom. Crawling.
Right here, my brother moved spots. This is in between Buckingham Point and that, I don't know what that island's called, really. Wimlo Island's right behind that. But he's throwing a jerkbait, a Stacy right here, just to the left of that cone, that buoy. There's a little underwater, like, little rock pile right there. Same thing, catches a couple dinks, they won't do much, really. But it's pre-fishing, so sometimes you eliminate water, sometimes you find water. It just depends on the day. Sometimes it's good when you have a bad pre-fish and you know where not to go, and you go out there and you hit all the water all the big ones are on and you haven't hooked them yet. So, you know, there's two ways of looking at it. There's never any bad pre-fish.
Well, that's two casts in a row on a jerkbait, so establishing a secondary pattern.
Sun comes out, so he goes and he's trying, I think this is along Highway 20, just throwing a jig and just dragging a jig down there. That's just a slow tapering bank, real rocky, always year round good spot for jig. Another small fish. So he goes over here just working the bank. I mean, it's Clearlake. Sometimes you can stumble upon big schools of them just going down the bank like you see people doing and just throwing around the docks. Throwing a BDS, guys been catching them. We've been catching them all year on that BDS around there. And then here again, just trying to jig because the sun comes out. Working just something a little bit slower.
He had tried deep cranking on this day too, and he said he couldn't catch anything, which surprised me. We do catch him, and then the video I'll be posting after this, day three. So, yeah, today overall this was just a real tough day for him out on the water. Stay tuned, watch next video posting. There's gonna be a lot of big fish catches and one huge one you don't want to miss. Thanks.
Finally. Well, that wraps up my day here. It was brutal today. Started shallow, nothing. Then found a few fish on that underspin around Kono Tei and missed a few more there. So there's something there, but worked the whole rest of the lake looking for deep spots all day and really caught two little dinks on a jig. So this is no good. Not a good first day. So my brother's gonna join me tomorrow, and I think we'll probably try fishing shallow a little bit more, since obviously the deep bite didn't pan out. So thanks for watching. If you like the video, go ahead and subscribe to the Bass Hookup, and hit the like button. And we'll try to do more of these where we're gonna let you follow us around pre-fishing for these tournaments, and then in a couple days it's gonna be the real deal. So thanks for watching.